Swine flu is basically a flu virus in pigs which transfers to human. But many of us don't know that H1N1 is not the only swine flu virus. In fact, swine flu strains have different types of viruses, and H1N1 is just one type of them. There are many other types of swine flu viruses named H1N2, H3N1, H3N2, and few more, which are basically subtypes of influenza A virus. There are few influenza C viruses as well. But what are influenza A and influenza C viruses? Let's simplify every bit of swine flu and understand this virus in all aspects. Hi friends, you're watching Mindscape, and let's explore the swine flu virus. Let's keep aside swine flu for now and focus on only influenza virus. The word influenza simply means flu, and it's spread through some or other virus into humans or animals. And these influenza viruses categorized in total 3 influenza viruses: influenza type A, type B, and type C. Influenza type A spread from wild aquatic birds. Type A is the most dangerous among the 3 when it comes to human. Type B, this virus almost exclusively infects humans and is less common than influenza A. This type of influenza mutate at a rate 2 to 3 times slower than type A, and consequently is less genetically diverse. Type C, which infects humans, dogs, and pigs, sometimes causing both severe illness and local epidemics. However, influenza C is less common than the other types and usually only causes mild disease in children. So when it comes to swine flu, there are a variety of viruses involved in a variety of swine flus. But when it comes to swine flu as a whole, it carries influenza A and influenza C viruses. And in type A, there are subtypes of viruses called H1N1, H1N2, H3N1, H3N2, and H2N3. And in this subtype, H1N1 is we all heard of, simply because it is more dangerous and caused many deaths during 2009 swine flu breakout. Swinefluenza virus is common throughout pig population worldwide. Transmission of this virus from pigs to human is not common and does not always lead to human flu, often resulting only the production of antibodies in the blood. If transmission does cause human flu, it is called a zoonotic swine flu. Zoonotic, name derived from zoonosis, a Greek word for animal, and zoonoses are infectious disease for animals that can naturally be transmitted to humans. These viruses can be transmitted from animals to humans through either air, which we call influenza transmission, and through bites and saliva, which we call rabies. Like swine flu, major modern diseases such as Ebola virus and HIV are zoonotic diseases. These zoonotic strains of swine flu rarely pass from humans to human, and mostly transferred from animal to human only. So the 2009 H1N1 virus was not a zoonotic swine flu, as it is not just transmitted from pigs to human, but it went further by transmitting it from human to human through airborne droplet. And that's where it became dangerous. So if swine flu virus can only transfer from pig to human, how it able to transfer from human to human at a first place? For this, we need to understand a virus infection in pigs. Swine can be infected by avian or bird flu strain, human flu strain, and pig flu strain. Most of swine flu contain only one strain of virus that transfers to human, but it cannot transfer further from human to another human. But during H1N1 breakout, a particular pig who got infected from a bird strain of influenza A virus got infected by a human strain of influenza A virus at the same time. And these two different strains got mixed, and new strain of influenza A was born. which was able to transfer from human to another human, simply because the newly born virus have a human strain of influenza A, which basically can infect human by another human. And that's how this strain of virus was able to spread faster from human to human contact. Swine flu or H1N1 is not first introduced to human in 2009. It is in existence for almost 100 years. The first H1N1 breakout happened in 1918, which caused 50 to 100 million human deaths worldwide and infected 500 million people. But it had a different name to the flu, the Spanish flu. Since then, the virus is still existed amongst us, but till 2009, it was not that serious. This is how swine flu evolved. But what happens when this virus infects to a human? Basically, H1N1 virus is like ordinary seasonal flu. You may not know this, but it has same symptoms, almost same diagnosis, and same treatment as a seasonal flu. But if it remains untreated, it becomes dangerous. When human body gets infected by H1N1 virus, it mostly starts affecting the ventilation system of a human body. That is respiratory system. This system uses specific organs to exchange gases, and it maintains oxygen and carbon dioxide levels. The system is vital to every living creature, from all animals to all plants. Considering specifically to humans, most important organ in this ventilation system are lungs. This ventilation system is what makes you breathe properly and spread oxygen into your body through blood. Simply failure in this system means you cannot breathe. So when H1N1 virus enters in human body, it results into inadequate gas exchange by a respiratory system, and both oxygen and carbon dioxide cannot be kept at normal level, resulting into increase of CO2 levels, which is called hypercapnia, and forming of drops in oxygen carried in blood cells called as hypoxemia, resulting increased work of breathing and eventually the death. And respiratory or ventilation failure is the most common cause of death due to swine flu. There are other causes of death like pneumonia, high fever that creates neurological problems and failure, dehydration from excessive vomiting and diarrhea, electrolyte imbalance and kidney failure. So who is at danger and can get infected by swine flu? Basically, anyone can get infected by swine flu. But we already discussed there are a variety of swine flus. The zoonotic swine flu, which only transfers from pigs to humans. So people who work in a swine poultry or farming are only at risk from zoonotic swine flu, which includes most types of swine flus and can be prevented by related vaccination. But when it comes to H1N1, everyone at risk, simply because it spread from human to human. But fatalities due to swine flu are more likely in young children and elderly. So if your age is between 19 to 40, you are comparatively less likely to die even after swine flu infection. So even if someone gets infected, what are the treatments? As I said earlier, that swine flu is similar to seasonal flu, and same antiviral drug that are used to treat seasonal flu works against H1N1 swine flu. A commonly used drugs like Tamiflu and Relenza works best. Antibiotics won't do anything for you, simply because this flu is caused by virus and not by bacteria. So how can we prevent it from spreading? There are three steps to prevent the spread. First, to prevent it in pigs. Second, to prevent transmission from pigs to human. And third, to preventation of its spread among humans. At first step, we can prevent flu in pigs by giving vaccination to pigs. At a second stage, where it transferred from pig to human, this can only happen at swine farms or veterinary facilities. So people who work in such areas should wear masks and gloves. As well, they should protect themselves by vaccination. And at third level, swine flu spread between humans. When infected people cough or sneeze, then the other people breathe in the virus or touch something with the virus on it, and then they touch their own face. So you should avoid touching your eyes, nose or mouth when you are in a public place. At individual level, washing hands frequently is the great shield against any viral infection. You can even use hand sanitizers. Another great tool in prevention is vaccination. There is no magic injection as a swine flu vaccination. The same flu vaccine that protects against seasonal flu also protects against H1N1 swine flu strain. You can get it as a shot as a nasal spray, and it teaches your immune system to attack the real virus. So how a vaccination protects you? A vaccination dose creates antibodies in your body. For a quick understanding, let's call them defense army. When swine flu virus enters into the body, this army comes to fight and kill the virus. And one dose of vaccination contains army which can fight for 10 days against this virus. But what if the virus survive more than 10 days? H1N1 virus is most dangerous in first 4 to 5 days of infection. It can only transfer to other human in that span. Simply after 4-5 days, it becomes less harmful and less spreadable. Altogether, if you look at swine flu, it is not that dangerous at individual level, and it is actually a regular flu. But when it comes to its spreading capability among mass population, it becomes the most dangerous. Just for example, take one imaginary city which has 10 hospitals. If there are 10 patients of a seasonal flu, they get attended in one day, and as they got treatment in time, they cannot spread it to other people. But when it comes to swine flu, if 10 people gets infected, they can immediately transfer it to any number of people. Let's say they transfers to 100 people in a single day. These infected people will be able to see the symptoms 2 days after the actual infection. Till then, they will have infected 1,000 people. So before even they go to take a treatment, they have already infected many people. So as number of patients grows, hospitals and facilities will be insufficient to treat people. Hospitals cannot treat the people with the speed at which it gets transferred to other people. So in such a way, it can become unstoppable and can infect entire city in no time. And like city, it can happen to a state, country or to entire earth. Yes, still at individual level, it is a regular flu. That's how it is so dangerous. That's it about swine flu virus. If you liked the video, please give us a thumbs up. And if you loved it, give me a friendly hug by subscribing the channel. Hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.